Hello friends, in this video let us discuss the speed control by variation of supply voltage in induction motors. So in our last video we have discussed the speed control by variation in supply frequency. So this method of speed control by variation of supply voltage is a slip control method. It is basically a slip control method with constant frequency. So the frequency is constant here with constant frequency and variable voltage. So by varying the voltage, supply voltage, you can vary the speed. So that means we need a variable voltage source for using this method of speed control, and this variable voltage source can be obtained from, or the variable voltage source can be your tap changing transformers, or it can be variac, which we say the auto transformers, or it can be a saturable reactors. So by using these auxiliary equipment you can feed the variable supply voltage. Now in general this method of speed control has various limitations, and due to those limitations we shall discuss what are the limitations, and due to those limitations this method of speed control is used only for loads where the torque required drops off considerably as the speed is reduced, and such characteristics you will find in the small squirrel cage motors driving the fans. So once again I am repeating, this method of speed control in general is used only for loads where the torque required drops off as the speed is reduce. So considerable torque required drops off as the speed is reduced, and you can find such characteristics in small squirrel cage motors driving the fan loads. So this is the important thing you have to remember. Due to the various limitations this is only employed for the characteristics where the torque required drops off as the speed is reduced. So here we can obtain a variable speed by supplying variable voltages. So if I now tell you about the torque equation at a torque equation of a running motor at a slip S. So let us consider the torque equation at running conditions for a given slip S. Then the torque can be given by, your torque can be given by K into S into, where K is a constant, S into E2 square into R2 upon R2 square plus S square into X2 square. So this is basically you can obtain by power is equal to torque omega, torque into omega, and power can be given by 3 into I2 square into R2 upon S. So by plugging the value of I2 you will obtain this equation, that is the torque equation in a running condition at a given slip S. So basically this is your torque equation, and at standstill, since the induced EMF, so there will be, since the EMF induced in the rotor E2 is at standstill, so at standstill you can approximate your E2, which is proportional to the supply voltage. So E2 can be approximated to the supply voltage at the standstill, since the EMF induced in the rotor is at standstill. So initially the rotor will be at standstill, then only the EMF gets induced. That means your torque will be equal to, so when I write this is E2 is proportional to V, it will get a new constant again, K dash into S into this will be V2 square into R2 upon R2 square plus S square into X2 square. So now here you can see your torque is proportional to square of the applied voltage. So this will be V square. So your torque of the motor is proportional to the square of induced EMF in the rotor, and this induced EMF in the rotor is approximately proportional to the supply voltage. So directly you can say the torque is proportional to the square of the applied voltage. And if I say about the slip, your slip maximum corresponding to torque. So slip corresponding to maximum torque can be given by R2 upon X2, and your slip corresponding to maximum torque has nothing to do with the variability in the supply voltage. So it is independent of voltage, and there will be no change in the synchronous speed. So with change in the supply voltage, there will be no change in the synchronous speed. So synchronous speed doesn't get affected and your slip also doesn't get affected, but with change in the voltage, only the speed of induction motor, that is the rotor speed, gets affected. So these are the things you have to remember. Now if I consider a rated speed, or you can say a full load speed, so for a full load speed, the torque, that is the slip value, is minimum, because for full load speed or the rated speed, you are having some around, let me say, some 1500 rpm, then at that full load speed, the slip will be very small. So as the slip will be very small, because we know that slip can be given by ns minus nr upon ns, so when this approaches to the rated speed, then your slip will become a very small value. And for the, when the slip will become very small, then your term S square into X2 square, this term S square into X2 square becomes very small. So for a rated speed or for a full load speed, you can neglect this term, you can neglect this term, and we are left with your torque will be equal to K dash into S into V square into R2 upon R2 square, and this will be equal to K dash S into V square upon R2 square. Or you can write your torque is proportional to SV square. So this is the important thing you have to keep in mind when you study this speed control by variation of supply frequency. So torque is proportional to slip into the voltage square. So now if I plot the torque speed characteristics, so this is my percent full load torque, and this is your percent slip, or you can say percentage speed. So your slip will be S is equal to 0 here and S is equal to 1 here, and similarly, that means your slip is increasing in this direction, where your speed is increasing in this direction. This is your percent speed and this is your percent slip. Now if I say I'm having a torque load, so let me say your torque load is, so this is your torque load. Now what I consider is, I will take three voltages. So first I will take a rated voltage, first one is a rated voltage, and the second voltage is 1 by root 2 times the rated voltage V1, and third one is 1 by 2 times V1. So for these three voltages, I will observe the torque speed characteristics, thereby we can know how good we can control the speed of induction motor by variation of supply voltage. So basically, if I plot the torque speed characteristics, then these characteristics will be obtained for the rated voltage. This is for your rated voltage, and this is for your V2, that is 1 by root 2 times the rated voltage, which is nothing but 70.7% of the rated voltage, and this is for the 50% of rated voltage. This is 50% of V1, this is 70.7% of V1, and this is your V1, that is rated voltage. So here you can see the slip corresponding to maximum torque remains same, that means it doesn't get affected by variation in the supply voltage. So supply voltage has nothing to do, because S maximum corresponding to torque will be R2 upon X2, and this is independent of the supply voltage. So your slip maximum will remain same, that is slip at the corresponding maximum torque will remain same. And you can see, for a large variation in the voltage, so here you can have the full 100% voltage, and here you are having 50% voltage. So for a large change in the speed, you can change in the supply voltage, you can see the small change in the, let me say this is N1, this is N2, this is N3. So for a large variation in the supply voltage, you will see a small change in the speed. That means this has a very poor speed control range for a large variation in the supply voltage. So this is the thing also you have to keep in mind. This can be said as a limitation. So if I consider a rotor equivalent circuit referred to the stator, so let me say I am having a rotor equivalent circuit which is referred to stator. So when it is referred to stator, you will be having the equivalent circuit as, so if I draw the equivalent circuit here, so basically there will be a reactance, rotor reactance referred to the stator per phase, and there will be a rotor resistance referred to the stator per phase, and here will be tapping, and this is referred to the stator. So here the voltage will be V1, and I am neglecting here the stator voltage drops, that is R1 X1 drops. So I am left with, this is your X2 prime and this is your R2 prime, where X2 prime can be given by X2 upon K square, where K is the transformation ratio, and this is R2 prime upon S, sorry, and here we are having R2 prime upon S will be equal to R2 prime upon K square into S. So this is basically the rotor equivalent circuit referred to the stator side, and these are all the per phase quantities. So from here I can write my I2 dash, that is I2 prime, will be equal to V upon, that is the voltage, let me write this as V. So V upon under root of R2 prime upon S whole square plus X2 prime whole square. So this is basically the rotor current when the rotor equivalent circuit referred to the stator side. Now considering the full load speed or the rated speed, at full load speed you will be having a small value of slip. Now when you are having a small value of slip, your R2 prime upon S will be very much greater than your X2 prime. Now when this R2 prime upon S will be very much greater than X2 prime, you can neglect this X2 prime here, and we are left with your I2 prime will be given by S into V upon R2 prime. So this is a very important equation you have to remember here. So this is your first equation you have to keep in mind, and this is the other equation you have to keep in mind. Now when we say that the voltage or the rated voltage is reduced by a factor of 1 by root 2, so let me say this is V2 and this is V1. So your voltage is reduced by a factor of 1 by root 2. Now when we say this voltage is reduced by a factor of 1 by 2, basically this is the torque speed characteristics you will obtain for that voltage reduced by a factor of 1 by root 2. Now when the voltage is reduced by a factor of 1 by root 2, if you see your this equation where the torque is proportional to S into V square, so here you can see, if for a constant load torque, if I say the torque is constant, so when I say the torque is constant, your slip will be inversely proportional to 1 by V square, and if I say the voltage, now we have seen is 1 by, it is 1 by root 2 into V square. So now you can see your slip will be twice of, that means your slip gets doubled here. So you can see this root 2 square will get 2, so 2 will come upside, and here we are having V square. So this is the expression for the slip you can find, where the slip gets almost double. So for the voltage, when you reduce to 1 by root 2, your slip gets double by this equation, or in other way you can find this by, you can write it as, for initially let me consider T1 is proportional to S1 V1 square upon T2, this will be equal to S2 V2 square, and you can put the value of V2 is equal to 1 by root 2 into V1, and this for a constant load torque, this will be, you can cancel, and you will be left with your S2 will be 2 times of, that is 2 upon V1 square. So that means your slip will get double when you reduce the voltage to by a factor of 1/2. And if you see the current, so here when you reduce the voltage by a factor of 1/2, your current I2 dash, it will be proportional to V upon, it will be, so here we have seen that the slip is double, that means you are having slip value 2. So this 2 upon, now I am saying the voltage is reduced by a factor of root 2, that is 1/√2. So this will give you your I2 is proportional to, or it will be equal to root 2 times of the full load value. So for a, when the voltage is reduced by a factor of 1/2, your slip gets doubled. And now when the slip gets double, your rotor current will get the value, that is rotor current becomes the value root 2 times of the full load value. Now this excessive current may damage the windings, so you have to be extremely careful while using this method of speed control, that the excessive current should not damage the motor when the speed is reduced. So when the speed is reduced, you have to be careful such that the motor doesn't get damaged by this excessive current. So if you see the advantage of this method of speed control, so it has, this method is very simple. So you can use the variable voltage source to vary the voltage. So this method is a simple method, and this method has a low first cost. So the first cost means the cost employed for your auxiliary equipment is low, and this has a low maintenance. This method has low maintenance. So basically these are the three advantages you can find this method, but there are various limitations. So one limitation you can say, you cannot exceed the operation above the rated voltage. So if we see, this is the rated voltage characteristics, and here in this method of speed control, we cannot exceed the operation beyond the rated voltage, because there will be a term called magnetic saturation comes into the picture. So your magnetic saturation limits or restricts the operation beyond the rated voltage. So that is one drawback, or you can say the limitation. And another limitation is, for a wide variation in the voltage, that is the supply voltage, you will see a small variation in the speed. So this is the second drawback. And the third drawback is the torque developed. So basically this is your full load torque. So the torque developed by the motor reduces to a great extent when you reduce the voltage. So there may be a situation where the load torque, so this is the characteristics of your load torque. So there may be a condition where your load torque may exceed the T maximum, that is the pull out torque or the breakdown torque, where the if the motor exceeds the maximum torque, the motor will come to standstill. Now in case your load torque exceeds this torque maximum, so here you will get the breakdown torque or the pull out torque, or you can say the maximum torque, after which the motor comes to standstill. Now here you can see, after this range, if you are having the load torque, so this is your load torque. Now after this range, the motor will come to standstill. After T maximum range, if the load torque is increased beyond the maximum torque, so this is the load torque characteristics and this is the maximum torque. So these load torque characteristics, if increased beyond this full load torque for the maximum torque for the breakdown torque, your motor will come to a standstill position. So this is the third limitation. And there is another limitation, there is a fourth limitation is, these the range of operation is very narrow here, the range of speed control is very narrow, and it is in downward direction. That means you can reduce your speed from the rated speed to lower speed only. Rated speed to lower speed. So you cannot go beyond the rated speed, and you can see the range of operation is a very narrow range. So due to these limitations, in general these motors can be useful for the loads only where the where the torque required drops off considerably as the speed of the motor is reduced, and that can be seen in the small squirrel cage motors driving the fan loads. So this is all about the speed control by variation of supply voltage in induction motors. I hope you understood well. Please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.